Did I cause others to suffer? I respect that question, and you for it. The most I can say is, I did the best I could, as I saw things. Can you, mortal, presume to judge the actions and motives of a god? But, because I need you, and you need me, I will make an accounting for my sins to you. But not now. Destroy Dagoth Ur, and then we will discuss my sins. Then, perhaps, you will have earned the right to judge me.
Come to the Heart Chamber. I wait for you there, where we last met countless ages ago. Come to me through fire and war. I welcome you. Welcome, Moon and Star. I've prepared a place for you. God. welcome, Nerevarine. Together we shall speak for the law and the land, and shall drive the Mongol dogs of the Empire from Morrowind. You honor the sixth house and the tribe unmourned? Come to me openly and not by stealth. Welcome, Moon and Star, to this place where destiny is made. It began here. It will end here. Have you any parting words, or would you prefer to skip the speeches and get to our business? You are the challenger here, after all. So to you goes the courtesy of the first blow. Now that you have come to me here, there can be but one result. Many times I have considered offering to share this place with you. I considered offering to accept your oath of service. You might try to buy my trust by giving me Wraithguard, Keening, and Sunder. I thought we might once again be friends, comrades, brothers in arms. But I have won this place in power by right of conquest, by right of daring and enterprise. I will not risk it to cunning and deceit. I offer you no deals. If you are my enemy, I cannot trust you. And even if you are not my enemy, I cannot let you live. It will all be decided here. I believe I will prevail, but I cannot be sure, and I am vain enough that, should I fall, I would wish to be remembered in my own words. So, if you have final questions you would ask, ask them now. I have final questions I would ask you, if you would answer. My first question is, are you really Nerevarine reborn? That is bitter. The gods and fates are cruel. I served you faithfully once, Lord Nerevar, and you repaid me with death. I hope this time it will be you who pays for your faithlessness. My second question is, if you win, what do you plan to do with the power from the heart? Will you make yourself a god and establish a thearchy? Or will you complete a Kulakan and dispute control of Tamriel with the Septums? Or will you share the heart with your followers, as I have, and breed a new race of divine immortals? Well, perhaps there may be surprises in store for me yet. Or perhaps you obscure your plans on principle. Or perhaps you are an instinctive bluffer. No matter. My final question is, if I had offered to let you join me, would you have surrendered Wraithguard, Sunder, and Keening to me to seal your oath? An interesting response. You might have been willing to join me, but never to surrender the tools. Very interesting. I'm glad I didn't try to bargain with you. And now, if you have any questions, ask them. Otherwise, you are the challenger. I await your first blow. What are your questions? A Kulakan will serve three purposes. First, it will be the champion of my armies, liberating first Vardenfell, then Morrowind, and then perhaps the rest of Tamriel. Second, it will serve as a sower and cultivator of the divine substance derived from the heart. Three, it will serve as the prominent banner and symbol of our cause, to defy the Empire, to liberate mortals from ancient superstitions, and to glorify our crusade against the gods. What are your questions? I will continue to draw divine power from the heart and distribute it to my kin and followers. I will continue to broadcast divine power upon the blight winds so that it will touch each soul on Vardenfell, and then, more broadly, across the waters to the rest of Morrowind and Tamriel. In time, every mortal in Tamriel shall feel the liberating contact with the divine. What are your questions? If, by my crimes, you mean the inevitable suffering and destruction caused by war, then I accept the burden of leadership. The Sixth House cannot be restored without war. Enlightenment cannot grow without the risk of upsetting the tradition-bound and complacent herd. And the mongrel armies of the Empire cannot be expelled from Morrowind without bloodshed. As I have charity and compassion, I grieve. But our mission is just and noble. What are your questions? I will free the Dunmer from the Imperial yoke and cast down the false gods of the Temple. I will lead them out of their ancient superstitions and gift them with intimate knowledge of the Divine. Then, perhaps, when Morrowind is once again restored to its ancient glories, it will be time to consider whether the Dunmer should cultivate ambitions of empire. What are your questions? The Sixth House will serve as the elite cadre of our movements. As cultists evolve through various stages of enlightenment, they will become, as suits their abilities, either holy warriors or priests. Their duty is to prepare themselves for service. Their joy and liberation is to enter ever more deeply into the profound enlightenment of the divine dream world. What are your questions? I have no idea what happened to the Dwemer. I've been denied the opportunity to study Wraithguard, and I am not sure how much of Kagranak's lore was invested in his tools. and how much in his own sorcery and mastery. I have long studied Kagranak, and have come to admire his wisdom and craft. Someday, after the campaigns of the Sixth House are secure, I hope to have time to dedicate to this mystery. What are your questions? Very well. If you are impatient to begin, go ahead. You are the challenger. To you goes the first blow. Intoxicating innocence. How could you be so naive? There is no escape. No recall or intervention can work in this place. Come, lay down your weapon. It is not too late. Thank you.
You no longer bear the burden of prophecy. You have achieved your destiny. You are free. The doomed Dweemer's folly, Lord Dagoth's temptation, the tribunal's seduction, the god's heart freed, the prophecy fulfilled. All fate sealed and sins redeemed. If you have pity, mourn the lost. But let the weeping cease. The blight is gone, and the sun's golden honey gilds the land. Hail, Savior, Hortator, and Nerevarine. Your people look to you for protection. Monster and villains, great and small, still threaten the people of Vardenfell. Enemies and evils abound, yet indomitable will might rid Morrowind of all its ills. For you, our thanks and blessing, our gift and token given. Come, take this thing from the hand of God.